Matthew Griswold started to play the guitar when he was 15.
It wasn't even an addiction, it was just a passion.
Like some teens play video games, I play the guitar. I came home from school and just started playing immediately. I'd play well into the night.
Play something, man.
When he was 21, he enlisted in the Army. In 2006, Matthew saw lots of action in Iraq.
Ramadi was about the most hostile area you could be, and it did come to be one of the most violent campaigns of the entire Iraq war.
Good to see you guys.
He served for 5 years, and when he got back home, he had problems.
A lot of us see it as a weakness, and it's not a weakness, it's just a truth. And for us to confront that, we need to accept the truth.
Military behind him, he started to perform all over the Midwest. And now, 3 years into his music career, he's living a dream.
And I feel real good tonight. We got music playing for the
state. I feel like I've already accomplished my dream. I feel like just being able to do this as often as I can. When I wrote my first song, I knew right away that that was going to be what I wanted to do the rest of my life.
Outside in the cold distance, the wild candy growled, ay, 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 ay. Two robbers were approaching, the wind began to howl. The wind began to howl. The wind began to howl.
Thank you.
It's fun, and it's painful in a delightful way, and it's honest.
Matthew found out his music can help veterans.
Music has a weird way of making the worst situations even feel safe when it's in song. And so there's a lot of benefits to using music as a form of therapy. I give a presentation out at the VA Med Center pretty frequently, and I work with MACV, Minnesota Assistance Council for Veterans, very frequently, and I performed at a number of their events, and I come out and I talk to some of their veterans that are in a pretty tough place in life, and try to remind them that we're all in this together.
Nobody knows.
200 performances a year, he wishes it was even more.
200 is not enough. I'd love to do 400 shows a year.
Lie, lie, lie.
No, I'm not married. I think I've reached a place in my life where I'm maybe ready to get married, but I'm not married yet.
I wrote a song for everyone. I wrote a song for you. I wrote a song for everyone. But I couldn't even talk to you.
My parents are still alive. They're some of my biggest fans. They had a change of heart. I think maybe early on they were kind of like, no, you got to do something else, and they had all these ideas as to what I should do, and now they're always in the front row of my shows, and I think they love seeing me happy, love seeing me do what I do now.
All right, thank you all very much. We'll see you soon.
Thank you so much.
Fabulous.
John Gross, 5 Eyewitness News.
Sitting back there. That's a treat to have people
Wonderful.
Sit and just listen. That was awesome. Thank
it's
you.
It's just delightful.
Oh, thanks so much.
Oh,
thanks so much. I saw that.